Yo, what is up guys, Punkerzz here, and today I am back with another video for you guys, and today I'm going to be trying something a little different. I'm going to be doing my own rendition of a top 5, and as you can see, it's going to be the top 5 things to do when bored in Advanced Warfare. Something very different on my channel, but I thought I'd give it a try. So from the late night grinders to people who are just now playing the game, Call of Duty can get boring at times. So in today's video, I'm going to tell you guys 5 things to do when bored in Call of Duty, specifically Call of Duty Advanced Warfare. But guys, I don't know how well this video is going to do, so let's try and hit 20 likes. That would be awesome. But without further ado, let's get started. Number 1. If you guys are like me, you get tired of playing the same maps day in and day out. So what I'm going to recommend to you guys for tip number 1 is to go try some DLC maps. They're not that expensive. They're only about $14 on the Xbox Live Marketplace and can really bring a whole new feel to the game. As you can see right now, I'm playing on a map named Skyrise, which is a rendition of the map Highrise from Modern Warfare 2, which is a game I used to play a lot when I was younger. So having a map from Modern Warfare 2 come back to a game like Advanced Warfare that I play much more frequently nowadays can really bring a whole new look to the game and make it much more enjoyable. Number 2. Along with new DLCs, I would recommend trying out new playlists. As you can see right now, I'm playing on a grapple playlist, which is basically like normal Advanced Warfare, but instead of having things like Overclock and Exomute, you're going to be having a grappling hook that shoots out of your arm across the map, lets you fly everywhere, and also kill people with the grappling hook if your aim is just right. This playlist almost single-handedly got me back into playing public matches a couple of months ago when I was getting a little bit bored of the game, so I'd highly recommend trying it out and let me know if you enjoyed. Number 3. Sometimes trying new maps isn't quite enough to give your game a brand new feel, but what I like to do is try out new guns that I would never use in a competitive atmosphere. For example, the M1 Irons is a sort of Wild Wild Western revolver that you whip out and you have 6 shots to kind of hit people with. It has high damage, but is very hard to use. Now myself, as a competitive player, would never get to use this in a real match, you know, a scrim or a tournament or a GB, whatever it may be. I don't even think I'm allowed to use it, much less would use it if I had the choice. So it's definitely a gun that I can mess around with in a public match and really just have a good time, look at the animation, and just all around give my game a new feel that I don't really get to experience when I'm actually trying. Number 4. While a lot of people, like myself, tend to stick to the multiplayer side of Call of Duty, we can't forget that there's a whole nother game mode that is untouched by a lot of the community named Exo Zombies. Exo Zombies is where you spawn into a post-apocalyptic world where a bunch of undead minions come up from the ground and whose main goal is to kill you. You upgrade guns over time and basically try to stay alive as long as you possibly can, moving up through the rounds to have bragging rights over your friends, or you can kind of grab a couple of your friends and try and make it as high as you can with them, have a little bit more fun with your friends outside of school or wherever you may be. So be sure to go try Exo Zombies if you have a free time between matches, or maybe a day where you're not really doing anything, and try and make it as far as you can. Number 5. So this last tip may seem a little bit silly to you guys, but if you ever really get so bored of Call of Duty that you can't find anything else to do, just put down the controller and go try and find something else. Or if you just want to try a whole new game altogether, Destiny, Titanfall, or a computer game such as League of Legends, CSGO, whatever it may be, just take a break from Call of Duty for a while and come back when you actually want to play it. It's always a pretty good road to take if you really cannot find anything else to do.
Man, dude, I was like 9 off my DNA bomb, man. Screw it, man, whatever.